Friends, we will continue the topic Bronsted lowry acid base theory. Okay, so already discussed about Bronsted lowry acid base theory. It is also called as protonic theory. Am I right? It is also called as protonic theory. That means with respect to H plus, here we explained about Bronsted acid and Bronsted base, so we call it is protonic theory. So according to this theory, so this is the substance, am I right? This is the chemical substance. Now proton donor, that is H plus donor, is called as acid according to this theory, Bronsted lowry acid base theory. Now it is the chemical substance. Suppose this substance donate the proton to any other compound, then this compound is called as Bronsted acid. Okay, Bronsted acid. Suppose this compound is proton acceptor. Proton acceptor, proton donor and proton acceptor, then this compound is called as base. So this one we call it is Bronsted acid. Then the substance is called as Bronsted acid. Now this one is called as Bronsted base. The substance become Bronsted base, and this one is called as, then the substance is called as Bronsted acid. If the substance donate H plus, then we call it is Bronsted acid. Okay, if the substance accept the proton, then we call it is Bronsted base. Is it clear, ma? So some example regarding this one, HCl. Okay, it can able to lose the proton very easily. Okay, now this is called Bronsted acid. Is it okay? Okay, so let's see the example for Bronsted base. Now this one is ammonia, so it accept the proton. So it accept the protons, then it gives NH4+ ammonium ion. Okay, accept the proton. So we call it is Bronsted base. Then we call it is Bronsted acids. Okay, is it clear, ma'am, to everyone? So in this theory, is there any discussion about medium? But in Arrhenius theory, he mentioned in aqueous medium, the presence of aqueous medium. Am I right? So in Bronsted lowry acid base theory, there is no mention about medium. Is it clear? So here the main important thing is, no mention about medium. Like aqueous medium, in Arrhenius theory, no mention about medium, there is no discussion about medium, like it is a aqueous medium or whatever it, okay? But in Arrhenius theory, he mentioned about aqueous medium only, okay? So no mention about aqueous medium. That means he doesn't discuss about medium in presence of, okay? So no medium here. Let the reaction between HCl and ammonia is reversible. Now this is Bronsted acid, am I right? Now this one become Bronsted base. Is it clear? Why? Because it is Bronsted acid. it can able to donate the proton to ammonia, am I right? So proton donor is clearly, is it clear? That means it gain proton, then it becomes NH4 plus. So now this one is called as acceptor, this one is called as donor. Simply H plus donor, where it is H plus acceptor. H plus acceptor. Okay, we call it is ammonium ion. Ammonium ion. Ammonium ion. Ammonium ion. Is it clear, ma? So where it is Bronsted acid, Bronsted base. Okay, so here it is actually gas. This one is also gas. Okay, is it clear? And this one is clearly here Cl minus. So this compound is called as NH4Cl, that is solid state. In solid, ammonium plus Cl minus as ammonium chloride, that is in solid state. Where it is in gaseous state, where it is in gaseous state. Okay, there is no particular medium he mentioned, it is aqueous medium or is there another medium. Okay, so no mention about medium. Whatever the medium, the reaction proceeds. Okay, either forward or backward. The main concept is here proton donor, proton acceptor. Remember the point, there is no medium mentioned in Bronsted-Lowry acid base theory. But in Arrhenius theory, he mentioned about medium, that is aqueous medium only. So in the aqueous medium, the substance gives H plus, then we call it is Arrhenius acid. Suppose it gives OH minus, then we call it is Arrhenius base. He mentioned about aqueous medium in that concept, but in Bronsted-Lowry acid base theory, he doesn't discuss about medium. So which kind of medium we used here, either aqueous or any other medium. Okay, so there is no mention about medium, that point is important. Okay, so now this is example regarding Bronsted acid base theory. We already discussed some example. Okay, is it clear, ma? Now the next concept is amphoteric nature of water. Amphoteric nature of water. Here what is meant by amphoteric nature? Amphoteric nature of water. Okay, amphoteric nature, before that we discussed here. So what is meant by amphoteric nature? The substance which can act as an acid and also base. The substance which can act as acid and also base, then we call it is amphoteric nature. Amphoteric nature. Okay, the substance which can act as an acid and also base, then it is called amphoteric substance. Amphoteric substance and that nature is called amphoteric nature. A substance can act as both acid and base, then we call it is amphoteric substance. Okay, example here water can act as amphoteric substance. Example, H2O act as acid and also base. Here water can able to act as acid and also base, so water is called as amphoteric. So water is called as amphoteric substance. Is it clear, ma'am? Is it clear, all of you? H2O, where water act as acid and also base, the substance which can able to act as acid and base is called as amphoteric substance. So let's see the example regarding that H2O act as an acid and base also in the reactions. So we called as amphoteric substance. So this is the example for amphoteric nature. Okay, so let's see how it is act amphoteric in nature in the chemical reactions. Okay, let's see the example. Is it clear, all of you? Let's see the example. This is the compound HCl, and add water to this. Okay, HCl you know very well, acid. Am I right? Is it clearly? Acid. Now here it act as base. Suppose this one is acid, this one becomes base. Remember this. Now this can able to donate the proton to water. That means proton donor. Then it becomes H3O plus. Keep plus when H2O gain a hydrogen. So then it becomes Cl minus. Is it clear? What is the name of this H3O plus? We call it is hydronium ion. Hydronium ion, chloride ion. Okay. So now it is proton donor. Am I right? This one is proton donor. Proton donor. That means it is clearly Bronsted lowry acid. Am I right? Now this gain the proton, that means it accept the proton from this HCl, so we call it is Bronsted base. Am I right? Bronsted base. Is it clear? So now what is the nature of water in this equilibrium reaction here? So where water act as is a base, am I right? In the above example, is it clear, man, all of you, everyone? Let's see the second example regarding this, where water act as acidic in nature. You know very well about ammonia, am I right? NH3. Now would like to add water to this H2O, am I right? Now this ammonia is a base, clearly, where water acts as acid. So now it can able to donate the H plus to the base, am I right? In this case ammonia is a base, here HCl is a acid, where HCl is acid, H2 act as base, where ammonia is a base and H2 act as acid. So acid, what is the nature of acid? According to Bronsted-Lowry acid base theory, it can able to donate proton to base, am I right? So now it is clearly proton donor, am I right? Proton donor. clearly proton donor, am I right? Is it clear, ma? So what about this one? Proton acceptor. Proton acceptor. So proton donor is called as ma? Bronsted acid, clearly. What about this one? Proton acceptor is called as Bronsted base. Is it clear, all of you? So now what are the compounds formed here? So NH4 plus and OH minus ammonium ion. So now what are the present in ions in H2O? So one is H plus, another one is OH minus, am I right? So now H2O donate H plus, what are the remaining one? OH minus as product. Okay, is it clear, ma? So that means water can able to act as base and also acidic in nature. So water is amphoteric in nature, am I right? Clearly, all of you. So such kind of compounds are called as amphoteric in nature. It's very simple. Is it clear for all of you? So next, very very important here, note it down. So that is water act as weak acid or weak base. Weak base, remember this. Water act as weak acid or weak base. Water can able to act as acid and base, but what is the nature of water here? Weak, either weak acid or weak base, remember this. So why it is weak acid or weak base, I would like to discuss now. So you know very well about pH scale. pH scale. Okay, so let's take the pH scale up to 0, and this one is 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. It actually starts from 0. Remember this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. This is pH scale range. Generally, pH scale range starts from 0 to 14. Okay? But in our books like this, okay? Remember this. So I would like to consider like this. Okay? pH from 1 to 14. So what are these values? pH values of a compounds. pH value of a compound. These are the pH values. pH is 1, pH is equals 2, pH equals 3, pH is 10, pH equals 4. According to pH scale, If pH is 7, then the compound is called as, such compounds are called as neutral compounds. That means there is no acidic and no basic. Neutral, if pH equals 7. If pH value is less than 7, they are in acidic in nature. The compounds are in acidic in nature. Am I right? Acidic in nature. If pH is greater than 7, they are in basic in nature, am I right? Basic in nature, is it clear? pH equals greater than 7. Those compounds are called bases, is it clear? So the next important point in this, at pH is equals to 7, neutral, am I right? Neutral. If less than 7, pH is less than 7 here. Those are called as acidic. Okay. pH is greater than 7. That means from here. pH is greater than 7. Those are called as basic nature. Is it clear? If pH is, remember, very very important, at lower pH, substances are strong acids. Remember this, strong acids. If pH is equals 1, it is strong acid. Is it clear, ma'am? Strong acid. If pH is equals 6.8 nearly, then it is weak acid. Remember this point, weak acid. 6.8, that means at this point. At here, those are very strong acid. Then strength of the acid is decreases by increase the pH value. Is it clear? So where 5, more than 6, they are become weak acid. Okay, is it clear? And come to here. If pH value near to 14, they are strong bases. Why? Because basic nature is increases like this. From 7 to in this direction, basic strength increases. Basic strength is increases. That means pH equals to 4 means strong base. So suppose pH is equals to 14 means that becomes very strong. Strong base. Very strong. Is it clear? Very strong base. Okay. So if pH is equal to 9, that means pH is equals 7.5 or nearly 7.3 or 7.1. They are weak base. They are weak base. Remember this. Okay. So strength of acidic strength is increases in this order. Acidic strength Acidic strength is decreases. So in this direction, acidic strength is decreases. In this direction, increases. Is it clear? This is the pH scale representation. Which one is strong acid? Which one is strong base? Okay. If pH value becomes more, then it becomes strong base. Okay. If pH value is increases, that becomes weak acid. So pH equals to 1 means that becomes strong acid. pH equals 6.9, 6.8, that means weak acid. Is it clear, ma'am? Is it clear? At pH is equals to 7 means that becomes neutral compounds like salts. They are salts. Okay. Is it clear? So now water act as a weak acid or weak base means weak acid means pH of water may be H2O is a weak acid means pH value nearly 6.9, sometime approximately 7, 6.9, that becomes weak acid. H2O is a strong, H2O is a weak base, we call, am I right? That means pH value nearly 7.1. That means nearly 7. Am I right? Nearly 7. 7.1 means it is nearly approaches to 7. If pH value is 14, that will become strong base. pH value nearly 7.1 means almost a 7. Am I right? That means the base going to be in neutral nature. Am I right? 7.1 is not exactly 7. 7.1 means that is weak base. So the pH of water is nearly 7. Nearly approaches to 7. Okay? At 25 degrees Celsius. So we call it is weak acid, or sometimes it acts as a weak base. Why? It is an amphotic substance. In some reactions it acts as an acid. In some of the reactions it acts as a base. So, and finally water acts as a weak acid and weak base. So why it is weak acid and weak base? For it is strong acid, the pH value is 1. But the pH of the water is nearly 7. So it is weak acid. Why? Because increasing in the pH value decreases the acidic strength. The acidic strength is decreases. So in this direction, what happened? Basic strength is increases. Am I right? Basic strength is increases. That means pH equals to 4. That means 14. That means very strong base. But in the case of water, pH value is nearly approaches to 7.1. That becomes very weak base. Is it clear? So let's see how it is happened. Is it clear, ma'am? So now we have formula according to pH scale. pH is equals minus log H plus to the base 10. To the base 10. H plus means here molar concentration. Molar concentration of H plus ion in the solution. In the solution. Is it clear? In the solution. Okay. So this phenomena is called as pH. Is it clear? If molar concentration of H plus ion is 0.001, okay, am I right? In molarity, then calculate its pH value. Then calculate its pH value. So in the question, he given molar concentration, then calculates its pH value. So molar concentration of H plus ions means that is taken as H plus, how much it is? 0.001. Am I right? Can I write like this above expression? So the point after 3 digits, so 1 into 10 power minus 3, am I right? So finally it is 10 power minus 3 m. Is it clear? Now keep this value in this equation. pH is equals to minus log, what is the value of H plus here? 10 power minus 3. 10 power minus 3. Here we have base 10. Am I right? Is it according to logarithm concepts? This power as coefficient, you know, minus, what is the power here? Minus 3. Then it becomes log 10 to the base 10. Am I right? So according to logarithm formulas, log 10 to the base 10 is the cost. 1. Now what is the value of this one? Log 10 to the base 10 becomes 1. Am I right? So finally pH is equals minus of minus plus 3. So what is the pH of the given solution? pH means here 3. 3 means it becomes strong acid. Am I right? Is it clear? Everyone? pH plus 3 means 1, 2, 3. That becomes strong acid. Suppose it is 6.9, then it becomes weak acid. It approaches to neutral 7. Okay, is it clear? Suppose H plus ion concentration is 10 power minus 14 molar. 10 power minus 14. Then what is pH? for this one calculate for the same compound calculate POH. POH we have the relation for base we calculate POH for base that is POH is equals minus log OH minus ion concentration to the base 10 formula for bases. Okay, remember this that we consider as POH. POH where it is molar concentration of OH minus. Okay, but we have the relation pH plus POH is equals always becomes 14. Remember this. How much it is? 14. So for the above example, what is pH value? 3. So keep this here. pH equals 10. Then what about POH? POH is equals to 14. From this one, POH is equals to 14 minus 3. Clearly it is 11. 11 means it's going to be weak base. In the pH scale 14, that is strong base. When decreases from 14, then it becomes to weak base. Am I right? So pH value is 11. That means it's going to be weak base. Is it clear, everyone? pH approaches to 14, that becomes strong base. pH approaches to 1, those are becomes strong acid. pHs are approaches to 7, those are weak acid. pH approaches to 7, those are becomes weak bases. Is it clear? So I told here water acts as a weak acid or weak base means these water pH nearly approaches to 7. Okay, is it clear? pH scale later we will discuss, we have a separate topic. So of it is water act as a weak acid or weak base means here at 25 degrees Celsius, at 25 degrees Celsius, very important. At 25 degrees Celsius, H plus ion concentration for water is taken as 10 power minus 7 molar. Remember this. How much? 10 power minus 7. At 25 degrees Celsius, H plus ion concentration of water, in water it is taken as 10 power minus 7 molar. What is the concentration? 10 power minus 7. Then calculate pH here. pH is equals minus log H plus to the base 10, am I right? Is it clear all of you? Now keep this value. Minus log 10 power minus 7 to the base 10. According to logarithm formula, this power as coefficient of log minus of minus 7 log 10 to the base 10, am I right? So minus of minus plus 7 log 10 to the base 10 1. So finally plus 7. pH is equals 7. pH equals 7 means it's nearly actually neutral, am I right? But can I write like this? pH is also right, 6.9 also in this case. That means waters become weak acid, am I right? pH is less than 7 also considered here. 6.9 means it is approaches to 7, am I right? So it is suppose less than 7, that means 6.9, can I write like this? 6.9 means near the 7. So 6.9 means maybe chance to act as weak acid water. Water acts as a weak acid in this case. So therefore H2O act as weak acid. Why? Because pH is nearly approaches to 7, that is 6.9 or 7. Okay, so at 25 degrees Celsius, at 25 degrees Celsius OH minus ion concentration of water is also 10 power minus 7 molar. Remember this. Okay, remember this. Now calculate POH. POH minus POH is equals to minus law OH minus ion concentration to the base 10. Is it clear? For bases this is the formula. Minus log, what is OH minus ion concentration? 10 power minus 7 to the base 10. So this is minus of minus 7 into 1, log 10 to the base 10. So finally what is POH? POH is equal to 7, am I right? So we know that pH plus POH equals to how much more clearly? 14. From this one, what is the pH of above solution? 14 minus POH. So 14 minus what is the POH value here? 7. That is equal to 7. For basic solution, what is the pH? 7. For the basic solution, POH is 7 and pH is also how much? 7 also. That means pH value for base nearly to 7, am I right? Nearly. That means pH is 7 means, can I write like this? 7.1 nearly. 7.1 means it's become basic in nature or not? Base. pH is equals 14. That is strong base. Strong base. Already we discussed, am I right? Where pH is equals just above 7. That means it is become weak base. That becomes it is weak base. Am I right? So where in this case pH is just 7.1 we taken. Just above. Okay? That means pH just above means that becomes weak base. Okay, is it clear? So water acts as a weak base and weak acid. It may be chance we have. Okay? At finally, this is the concept. Finally, note at 25 degrees Celsius. At 25 degrees Celsius, H plus ion concentration and OH minus ion concentration is taken as 10 power minus 7 molar. Okay? And they for water. Is it clear, man? For water? Is it clear, all of you? Simply remember this statement. Water acts as a weak acid and also weak base. So it acts as an amphoteric substance. So this is about Bronsted-Lowry acid base theory. It has some advantages and also disadvantages. Advantages in Bronsted-Lowry acid base theory. Advantages. Okay. That is, it is a broad theory simply you can write as it is a better than Arrhenius theory. It is a better than Arrhenius theory. Okay, that means he give the more explanation for acids and bases than in Arrhenius concept. Okay, remember this. Most of the compounds acts. Most of the compounds include as bases and most of the compounds include as acids. So why become according to this theory, so many compounds are act as acids, so many compounds are act as bases. Why? Because if any compound can able to donate H plus, it act as acid. If any compound accept H plus, it act as a base. So according to protonic theory, most of the compounds act as a, why? Because they are having more H plus, it act as acid. Suppose it can accept more H plus, it can act as a base. Okay. According to this theory, if you observe number of compounds, in that more compounds are act as a acid, in that some of the compounds act as a bases, according to this theory. So let's see the example HCl. It process hydrogen or not, so act as acid.
H2SO4, it passes HNO as HNO3. HNO3, it has acid or not? Acid, hydrogen. So most of the compounds belongs to Bronsted acid theory according to H plus concept, H plus proton concept. So most of the compound including, here it is base means here we have ammonia, am I right? Cl minus, Br minus, these are all minus, they can able to accept the H plus, am I right? Suppose in this case NH4 plus NH3, if you offered H plus, it becomes NH4 plus, it becomes ammonia, that means proton acceptor, so it, NH3 might, this is, okay, it accepts proton, am I right? It becomes NH4 plus, is it clear? So, for Cl minus, if we add H plus, it accepts the proton, then it becomes HCl. So now this one is called as Bronsted base. So most of the compounds included in Bronsted base concept. Why? Because they accept the protons. So here most of the compound includes acids, that means they can able to donate protons to others. Am I right? For example, here HCl, it can able to lose the proton easily. Am I right? So it acts as an acid. Is it clear? So among so many compounds, some of the compounds belongs to acidic nature, some of the belongs to basic nature according to protonic theory. Why? Because those compounds which are having H, they belongs to acidic group, okay, according to this theory. Those are able to accept the proton, they can belongs to basic category. Am I right? So that is the advantages of Bronsted-Lowry acid base theory. And one more important thing, he doesn't mention about medium. He cannot mention about, medium. Medium is either aqueous or either any medium. Okay? Medium. Like Arrhenius. Like Arrhenius concept. In Arrhenius concept, he mentioned aqueous medium, but in Bronsted-Lowry, there is no particular medium he mentioned. Okay, that is one of the advantages in Bronsted-Lowry acid base theory. Is it clear, ma? Next, go to limitations or drawbacks of Bronsted-Lowry acid base theory. Is it clear, all of you? Are you following? So, after the concept, have to focus once again, listen the online video, okay, and if it is possible, make the notes and try to read each and every point and follow the model examples which one I wrote on the board, okay, and follow our material. If you have any doubt in that material, pass the question in my WhatsApp group, I can explain you, okay. Limitations. So limitations of Bronsted-Lowry acid base theory. That first important, very important concept directly which we have in this topic. Is that clear, ma? Limitations here. He cannot explain acidic nature of non-hydrogenated compounds. That means according to this theory, the compounds which are process hydrogen or proton, it only called as Bronsted acid, am I right? But example, but some of the example CO2 and SO2, copper sulfate and FeSO4, FeSO4, FeCl3, FeCl3 and aluminum trichloride, aluminum trichloride, boron trifluoride, boron trifluoride. Okay, so these compounds are act as acid. These compounds are all are acids, all are acids. So is there any hydrogen atom? No hydrogen atom. So no hydrogen atom in the above compounds. No H plus in above compounds. But they act as Bronsted acid, am I right? Bronsted acid. These are all acidic in nature, okay? But they act as acid, not Bronsted acid. Acids acidic in nature. So these are all acidic in nature, am I right? Even though they doesn't process H plus. So he cannot explain acidic nature of non-hydrogenated compounds. Okay? Can only explain about acidic nature of the hydrogenated compounds only. But in the above example, there is no hydrogen, but they act as acid. Why these are act as acids without hydrogen can't explain by arginine Bronsted lauryl acid base. Is it clear? So even though they doesn't process hydrogen, but act as acidic in nature as acids. Why it is happened, he can't explain this in this theory. Okay, he only explain only hydrogenated compounds only as acids like HCl. Okay, and the next point, he cannot explain basic nature. Basic nature of non-proton acceptor compounds. Proton acceptor becomes basis according to this theory. Okay, non-proton proton acceptor means they unable to accept the proton. Okay, unable to accept the proton, but they act as basis. So let's see the example. This is basic nature of non-proton acceptor compounds. You cannot explain. Example, calcium oxide, magnesium oxides. Both are basic in nature. Basic in nature. Am I right? But they cannot accept proton. They cannot accept the proton H+. H+ means proton here. These compounds cannot accept the proton, even though they act as bases, basic in nature. But according to Arrhenius' theory, the compounds which are accept the H+ only called as Bronsted bases. But how these compounds are act as bases, even they doesn't accept the H+, they can't accept the H+ from acid. Okay, but they act as base. There is no H+ acceptor condition. Okay, so it is calcium oxide only, but act as base. So why it act as base, that you cannot explain. So these are the important drawbacks in Bronsted acid base theory. So why CO2 and SO2 and copper sulfate act as acid, even they doesn't process H+, but they act as acids. They can unable to donate the H+, there is no hydrogen. Okay, so but act as acid, you can't explain. Okay, and calcium oxide, magnesium oxide, such compounds are act as bases, but they can't accept the H+. They cannot accept the H+. If those accept the H+, we call that Bronsted bases. Is it clear? But this doesn't accept H+, but act as the bases. That phenomena also not explained by Bronsted-Lowry concept. Okay, is it clear?
everyone, these limitations are important here we have. More than that, advantages also. Is it clear, ma, all of you? Are you following or not? Don't sleep. Try to open the books and practice the problems every day. Okay? This lesson is going to be end within 2 or 3 days. Okay? And once see about Bronsted Ori acid base theory, I briefly explain. Okay? In that especially conjugate acid base theory we need to explain once again. Just listen. Conjugate acid base theory. We already discussed here in this topic. Okay? Conjugate acid base theory. Okay? Listen. If an acid and base differ by a single proton is called conjugate acid base pair. Conjugate acid base pair. Then the acid base pair is called a conjugate acid base pair. That both acid and base differ by single proton, single H plus. Then we call it is conjugate acid base pair. Let's see one example. When HCl treated with ammonia. Okay. In this case, it donate H plus, am I right? Then it becomes NH4 plus. By the loss of H plus, the remaining one is Cl minus chloride ion, ammonium ion chloride ion. Am I right? Is it clear? Proton donor is called as Bronsted acid, am I right? Proton acceptor is called as Bronsted base, am I right? Okay. Now this is equilibrium reaction clearly. Okay. Is it clear? Now remember this. These negative ions are called as bases. Remember this. Bases. Negative ions are called as bases. Where positive ions are called as acids. Remember this always. Positive ions are called as act as acids according to this theory. Negative ions are called as bases. Remember this. Okay. Now, according to conjugate acid base pair theory, now which pair becomes conjugate acid base pair? Okay. Now this is HCl, which is Bronsted acid. Now this one compare acid base in the right hand side. In the left hand side take one acid. In the right hand side compare one base. Now it is HCl, am I right? Okay. This HCl lose the H plus, what it gives? Cl minus. That means compare these two. Now Bronsted acid, okay, this is base, you know, base. As it lose H plus, it gives Cl minus. Now in between HCl and Cl minus, acid and base, you know, how many protons are difference? Single proton. So now this pair is called as conjugate acid base pair, am I right? This is Bronsted base. Now Bronsted acid it is now, am I right? Why? Because proton donor, then it becomes Cl minus, which is act as a base due to minus. Okay, now this acid, Bronsted acid having conjugate base. Now this is base. That base is called as conjugate base. CB means conjugate base. This is a Bronsted acid. It has a conjugate base. Now what is that conjugate base? Cl minus.
bronzed acid, what is its conjugate base? Cl minus. It becomes conjugate base. Simply we can write as conjugate base of HCl is what it is, Cl minus. Is it clear all of you? Everyone? It's clear? Just listen. Acid lose the H plus, it gives Cl minus. Due to negative charge, it acts as a base. Let just consider forward direction. Forward direction. Now, how can we treat it as conjugate base? Now come to this one. It is a base, you know, bronzed by proton acceptor. Bronzed base where it is acid. Now how many H pluses are different here? How many protons are different? Only single. It is base, it is acid. How many protons are differences here in these two? Only single proton. Now this one, this pair is also become conjugate acid base pair or not? Now what is that pair? One is NH3 and another one is NH4 plus, am I right? Where it is bronzed base, okay? Now this is conjugate acid, it becomes conjugate acid. Bronzed base, then it is acid, this acid become conjugate acid in the forward direction. Bronzed base, what is the first, select the conjugate acid base pair. This is base and acid. How many protons are different in this two pair? Only one proton. So this belongs to conjugate acid base pair. Now conjugate acid base pair. Now this pair is conjugate acid base pair. Am I right? How many protons are different? Single proton. This is NH3, this is NH4 plus. Only one hydrogen, one proton is different. Now already NH3 is bronzed base, now it is acid. Now this acid is called as conjugate acid. Base has conjugate acid. And this base, bronzed acid has conjugate base. Bronzed base has conjugate acid. Is it clear? Bronzed acid has conjugate base. And bronzed base has conjugate acid. Is it clear? So now, this is the base. Now, base has conjugate acid. Conjugate acid of bronzed base, that is ammonia here, is what it is, NH4 plus, am I right, in the forward direction, NH4 plus. Is it clear? So simply remember, this is HCl, bronzed acid. That means it can able to donate the H plus. Then what are the ions present here? Cl minus. HCl donate the H plus, bronzed acid. Now this one is called as conjugate base. After this, what happened? This one becomes conjugate base of this acid. This is bronzed acid. Now this one becomes its conjugate base. Conjugate base of HCl is Cl minus. Suppose this is ammonia. It is a bronzed base. Suppose it accepts the proton. Okay. It gives NH4 plus. Okay. This is bronzed base. Now after gaining the proton, it becomes conjugate acid. That formal product is called conjugate acid of this ammonia. Okay. Is it clear? An acid lose H plus, then it gives conjugate base of acid. A base gain the proton, then it gives its conjugate acid of ammonia. Is it clear? Simply H plus lose, then the product is called as conjugate base. If H plus gain, then the product is called as conjugate acid of this base. Is it clear? So finally, what we give the statement here? That is, bronzed acid has its conjugate base in the same manner. Bronzed base has its conjugate acid, am I right? Bronsted acid as its conjugate base. Bronsted base has its conjugate acid.
Is it clear? Everyone?
Now write the question. Write the conjugate bases for the following Bronsted acids, not for that, but following amphoteric acids
means they can able to donate H plus. Simply we call it is Bronsted acids, am I right? Bronsted acid, amphoteric acids means they can able to donate H plus. Amphoteric means water can able to act as acid and also base. Not only water, if any compound can able to donate H plus, that means it acts as acid and base, then we call it is amphoteric. Where water acts as amphoteric compound, am I right? Amphoteric acid means now water can able to donate H plus simply. So some of the important amphoteric compounds. Amphoteric. Let's see HF amphoteric and H2SO4 HCO3 minus. These are the given compounds. Given. For this, in the question, have to write conjugate base. For the given, write the conjugated bases only. For these compounds, now write conjugate bases. If you want to write the conjugate base for the given, just to remove H plus from this one. Just to remove H pluses. From this compound, just remove H plus. Now what are the ions present? F minus. From this one, just remove H plus. How many hydrogens here? We have two. Just one, remove one H plus. Then what are the remaining? HSO4 minus one. If you remove one H plus, keep one minus here. If you remove one H plus, keep one minus here. That is minus. If you want to remove one H plus, keep one more minus here. Already we have one minus. So from this one, remove just one H plus from this compound. What it gives? Already we have one minus. When we remove one H plus, keep one more minus on the compound, remaining compound. That means CO3 minus 2. Is it clear, all of you? Here we have one H, just remove H plus, keep one minus remaining here. Here we have two, just remove one H plus. Keep on minus here, HSO4 minus. And what about here? Here we have one hydrogen, just remove that hydrogen. Instead of that, keep on minus here. Already we have one minus and it gets 2 minus now. Is it clear? Now write, this is, what are the conjugate base of this? These are the conjugate bases. These are the conjugate base of HF. Conjugate base of HSO4, this one. Conjugate base of HCO3 minus, conjugate base of this one. Now these are the given species in the question. Now write conjugate base for this one. Now what is the answer? Just remove hydrogen from this one. What is the remaining? F minus is the conjugate base of HF. F minus is the conjugate base of HF. And remove hydrogen from here to need to get conjugate base.
So how many hydrogens here? We have two hydrogens. Just remove one proton. Then what it is? HSO4 now. When we remove one H plus, instead of that we keep one minus. So now it is minus. Now HSO4 minus is the conjugate base of H2SO4. Is it clear? Now it is remove one H plus. CO3 minus is already. When we remove one H plus, instead of that keep one more minus. So now minus and minus into minus, minus 2, minus plus minus, minus 2. Is it clear? Now these are the conjugate bases of these given compounds. Is it clear, all of you? Just remove H plus. Not remove H plus from the compound or ion to get conjugate base. Conjugate base, is it clear? For conjugate acid, not add H plus to the compound or ion to get conjugate acid. To get conjugate acid, this is HCl compound. Suppose now need to get conjugate base. For this, remove one H plus from then it gives Cl minus, which one called as conjugate base. Is it clear? Now this is the compound NH3, Bronsted base. To the compound or ion to get conjugate acid, add H plus, adding of H plus. For Bronsted base, to get conjugate acid, add H plus. Now this one is called as conjugate acid.